Hello everyone. Today we will learn ADO.NET, that is Unit 4, and the major topics is ADO.NET architecture. First of all, what is ADO.NET? ADO.NET is a set of classes, a framework to interact with data sources such as database and XML files. ADO is acronym for ActiveX Data Object. It allows us to connect to underlying data or databases. It has classes and methods to retrieve and manipulate data. Following are a few of the .NET applications that use ADO.NET to connect to a database, execute commands, and retrieve data from the database. These are ASP.NET web applications, console applications, and window applications. Next, ADO.NET introduced data providers that are a set of special classes to access a specific database and execute SQL command and retrieve the data. The data providers are extensible. Developers can create their own providers for proprietary data sources. These are some examples of data providers such as SQL Server providers, OLEDB, ODBC, and Oracle provider. Various connection architectures are the following two types of main connection architectures. These are first connected architecture. The application remains connected with the database throughout the processing. Second is disconnected architecture. The application automatically connect and disconnect. During the processing, the application uses temporary data on the application side, which is called a data set. Next, here you can see ADO.NET architecture. Here, there are two types of partition here. First partition is for connected access and second is for disconnected access. Here, provider objects are mentioned. So first is ADO.NET framework data providers. These are first class is connection, which provide transaction. Second is command, which provides parameters. Third one is data reader. Fourth one is adapter, which provide a bridge between disconnected and disconnected architectures. So here you can see dataset is purely disconnected architecture and the connection command data reader are purely connected architecture. And a data adapter provide the bridge between connected and disconnected architectures. So data adapter include such commands like select, insert, update, delete, etc. Next, dataset is nothing but the purely disconnected architecture. Here, this disconnected object provides a space or a data location to store your data temporarily. So it will contain this much data table collections, and the data table contains data row, column, and constants, etc. Here, the whole data is managed under a data relation collections. So here, your connected and disconnected is compatible with respective database and XML. So it is called whole ADO.NET architecture, which is mainly divided in two types. First, this one is connected and this one is disconnected. Important classes in ADO.NET. We can also observe various classes in the preceding diagram, and they are connection class, command class, data reader class, data adapter class, and data set class. First, we will see connection class. In ADO.NET, we use these connection classes to connect to database. These connection classes are also managed transactions and connection pooling. You need to establish a connection class object for inserting, updating, deleting, and retrieving data from a database. The connection class allow you to establish a connection to the data source. The connection class object need the necessary information to discover the data source, and this information is provided by connection string. You need to supply a connection string in the connection class object. The connection string is a series of name value settings separated by semicolons. Here you can see the syntax of connection class. Wherever you need to create an object of a syntax connection class, you need to write in such a manner. First of all, you will write here the name of class. Here we are using SQL database, so here I have mentioned SQL connection class. Next is object, which is user defined any word. So here I have taken object name CONN equals to new SQL connection, and connection string is passed as a parameter while creating an object of SQL connection class. So here the whole syntax is like this: SQL connection CONN equals to new SQL connection, and connection string is passed. If you are using ODBC database, then you can write here ODBC connection CONN equals to new ODBC connection. If you are using Oracle, you can write here Oracle connection class in place of SQL connection. So wherever which is your data provider, this data provider's respective connection class is written here. Next, second is command class. The command class provides the methods for storing and executing SQL statements and stored procedures. The following are the various commands that are executed by the command classes. First is execute reader. The execute reader returns the data to the client as rows. Next is the execute reader would typically be an SQL select statement to or a stored procedure that contains one or more select statements. Second one is execute non-query. It executes a command that changes the data in the database, such as an update, delete, or insert statement, or store processes that contain one or more of these statements. Means what? Whenever we need to update, delete, or insert command, we have to write as execute non-query. Third one is execute scalar. This method only returns a single value. This kind of query returns a count of rows or calculated value. Means wherever we need only single value return, we can use execute scalar method. Fourth one is execute XML reader. SQL client classes only obtains the data from SQL Server 2000 database and using XML string, which returns an XML reader object. So these are four basically methods which can be used by command class of ADO. Here you can see the syntax of command class. You can write SQL command. Wherever you are using ODBC, you can write ODBC command. If you are using Oracle, you can write Oracle command. Then object and equals to new SQL command. Next, data reader class. .NET data reader object is used for accessing the data from the data stored and is one of the two mechanisms that ADO.NET provides. As we will remember, data reader object provides a read-only, forward-only, high-performance mechanism to retrieve the data from a data store as a data stream while staying connected with the data source. Must note this point, students. Data reader is only the object which can be used in connected data access. The object of data reader cannot be directly instantiated. So Instead, you must call the execute reader method of the command object and close the connection when you are done using the data reader. Otherwise, the connection remains alive until it is explicitly closed. Syntax of reader class is here. SQL data reader. Here object is my reader equals to my command dot execute reader. Execute reader is a method. Fourth one is data adapter class. A data adapter bridges the gap between the disconnected data table object and physical data source. The SQL data adapter is capable of executing the select, delete, update statement on a data source as well as extracting input from the result set into a data table object. The SQL data adapter class provides a method called fill to copy the result set into a data table. Here you can see the syntax of data adapter class. For data adapter, we need to write first command class. So here I have taken SQL command. Then object is SC equals to new SQL command. Here we can apply query and connection object. And wherever I'll write SQL adapter, its object is SDA equals to new data SQL adapter. And I need to write here select command. So the object of data adapter, that is SDA.select command equals to SC. That is nothing but the object of command class. Here you can see these are the properties of particular class, that is data adapter. These major four properties are select, insert, delete, and update. So each and every command is used with data adapter class. Next is data set class. A data set is disconnected architecture technology. It contains zero or more tables and relationships. When you work with a data set, the data in the data source is not touched at all. Instead, all the changes are made locally to the data set in memory. In the following example, you can see how to retrieve the data from SQL table and fill the data in object. We will see example of this data set in next lecture. Here you can see first of all syntax of data set. Here you can write data set, the object is DS equals to new data set. Next is data set provides a disconnected representation of result set from the data source and it is completely independent from the data source. Means wherever we will use the data set, it must be the purely disconnected architecture. Data set provides much greater flexibility when dealing with the related result sets. Here you can see the architecture of data set. You can also tell it is nothing but the disconnected architecture of ADO dotted architecture. Here data set is mentioned, it contains basically these three parts: data table, which contain row, column, and constraint, and last one is data relation. Next, data table class. The data table class represents the tables in the database. As you can see here, your table contains respective row, columns, and constraints. Here, as we are storing some data in your database, it must contain in row and column combinations. Wherever we need to add two-dimensional data, every time we need a table. So each and every data will be stored in data table, but that table is contained in particular data set. So here, each and every table collect multiple rows as well as multiple columns and respective constraints like primary key, foreign key, etc. constraints are also provided with this table. So data set will contain these all three collection classes. So first of all, table class, and table class will represent data tables in from database. It has the following important properties. And most of these properties are read-only properties except the primary key property. Here you can see these are the properties of data table class. You can see first property is child relations, which returns the collection of child relationship. Second is columns, which returns the column collection. Third one is constraints, which return the constraints collection. Fourth is data set, which returns the parent data set. Fifth one is default view, which return a view of the table, means what, in which view we can see the table as an output. It will be set by this default view property. Next is parent relations, which returns the parent relation collections. Second last is primary key, which gets and sets an array of the column as in primary key of the table. And last one is rows, which returns the rows collection. Next is major ADO.NET namespaces. So to use the program or to program in ADO.NET, we must need to add these one data namespaces while using programming. So first of all, first system.data is used while we are writing a definitions for column, relationship, table, database, rows, views, etc. We need to write system.data.sql client wherever we are using SQL server database, and SQL command, SQL connection, SQL data adapter classes are used. If we are using ODBC database in place of SQL, then we need to add system.data.odbc namespace. And if we are using Oracle client in place of any of this SQL or ODBC, these are all data providers. So if we are using Oracle, we need to write system.data.oracle client as a namespace. Thank you, everyone.